Welcome back and thanks for joining me again. Slightly different location today. This is going to be the first in a little series on radioactivity. Today we've got a couple of practical demonstrations of the difference between irradiation and contamination. So first of all, we're just going to have a brief look at irradiation. Let's put an object on the table here. Exposing an object to one of the four types of nuclear radiation, most usually gamma. So here we have what we're saying is a radioactive source, and now we're irradiating the object in the same way that we could irradiate our part of a human. And this is often used for sterilizing in hospitals. But what happens is the item doesn't come into contact with the radioisotope. So it's just receiving radiation. So in that process, it does not become radioactive. Now, contamination is different. This occurs where some of the radioactive isotope lands up on or in a material. So we're gonna have a little look at this, and I'm gonna get kitted up because I've got some pretend radioactive material. And what we're going to do is we're going to talk a little bit about how that does with contamination. So here's my pot of radioactive material. I promise you there's no product placement. So this is actually a bit of ash. So if we take some of that ash and put it out on there, we can also bring our object, and then what we'll see is that there's contamination that occurs. If you can see that on the glove, there's contamination on the finger, there's contamination on the little mini screwdriver, and there's contamination on the paper. So if I just try and scoot this away, what will happen is we'll be left with some little bits of, because doing sort of radioactive contamination indoors is not ideal. So we're left with some bits of contamination, and as mentioned, all these items have got contamination on them, including the pot has got little bits. So we would have to clean that off. And then the problem with that is that, of course, the items that you use to clean it, and quite often this is nasty acids such as nitric acid, that also is then contaminated. So there's a chain of contamination when you're working with this, and that is the problem, for instance, from nuclear fallout from when Chernobyl went up, and it is also applicable to all the material of a nuclear power station has become contaminated by the radioactive material contained in it during the processes of operation. So that is contamination. I hope that gives you a good idea how to differentiate between irradiation, where you're not in touch with the radioactive isotope, and radioactive contamination, where bits of the isotope land upon material or humans or animals. And of course we can measure this with a Geiger counter, and this is ticking away because there are little counts going on as we speak of background radiation. Thanks again for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, and I look forward to seeing you next time. Bye bye.